बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ आवर फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ क्लास 9th बॉयज़। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 5 विच इंक्लूड्स फैक्टराइजेशन। फैक्टराइजेशन एक्चुअली मीन्स टू राइट अ नंबर into product of its factors. Like as you see here, I have written 6 equals to 2 multiply 3. It means this is the factorization of the number 6. Again 12 can be written as 2 multiply 2 multiply 3. So this is the factorization of 12. And 2, 2 and 3 are the factors of 12. Similarly, 15 equal to 3 multiply 5, and 14 can be written as 2 multiply 7. So these are the factorization of these numbers. When we are going to factorize the algebraic expressions like x squared plus 2x, then we take common from the terms. If there is something common in the whole, the number of terms including in the algebraic expressions, then we take common from the terms. Like if we see here x squared plus 2x, there is x common in both the terms, so we take x as common, taking x as common, and take a bracket and write the numbers which are left over here. As we have taken x as common, so there remains x, so we write x in the bracket, and from 2x we take x as common, so 2 is left here. So x into x plus 2 is the factorization of x square plus 2x, where x and x plus 2 are the factors of x square plus 2x. Again, if we are given the expression 2x square plus 4x plus 6, there is a number 2 which is common in all the terms. Like 2 is here, 2 is here, and 2 is also here. But there is no other term common in these 3 terms. So we take 2 as common, and the remaining terms are written inside the bracket. Like x squared, here is 2x. And when we taken 2 from 6, 3 remains inside the bracket. Here we have written 6 equal to 2 multiply 3. So 2 taken as common. So the next factor, which is 3 is remain inside the bracket. So this is the factorization of this expression. If we are given the expression like this, how we can factorize it? As you see, there is a number common 2, here is also 2, here is also 2. So we can take common 2 in whole the expression. Also A is common, A is present also here, A is here, so A is also common. B is here, B is also in this a term, and B is also in this term, so B is also common. So 2AB is common in all the terms. So we take 2AB common, 2AB common, and we remains C is here, minus 2X is here, plus D is here. Further, there is nothing common in these 3 expressions, C, 2x and D. So this is the complete factorization of such expression. If we see this one, there are 4 terms, 1, 2, 3, 4. And all the 4 terms, there is nothing common in all the 4 terms. But if we see these 2 terms, there is a number common which is a, and in these two terms there is a number common which is b. So we take a is common from here, and we left with inside the bracket 5x minus 3y. Similarly, b is common from here, and there is a negative sign, so we write first negative sign, taken b is common, and we remains inside 5x, and b is common from here, so this is 3y. And what sign may be written here? Because negative sign is here, the this sign will be changed. If this is plus, we write it here minus, and if minus sign is here, we write it here plus. Why? When we write, if there is the negative sign, there is negative sign, so we write plus as minus, because when we multiply b inside the bracket, then minus minus plus b into 3y, this is plus 3by. The same terms will come. Now these two terms are here, and what is the common in these two terms? 5x minus y, 5x minus y. So we take 5x minus y from these two terms. We have 5x minus 3y common, and we remain inside. In this terms we have taken 5x minus 3y common, a is here only. Again, from this term we have taken 5x minus 3 common, so we left with b here. There is nothing common in a and b, so this is the complete factorization of this expression. Now we solve another type of the factorization. If we see here x square minus y square into z plus y square minus z square into x, there is nothing common in these two terms. So in such expressions, we first multiply z inside and x inside the bracket, and what will become? Z into x square z, and y square into z, then y square into x, and z square into x. We have now four terms, and we first see, is there anything in all the four terms common? No. Then we treat as this question as the above one. See here, we have pairing in this question. Take the first pair of these two terms and the second pair of this. Similarly, we make pairing here. First of all, we write x square z, and there is a term in which z and x occurs, so we write z square x close to this one. So we can take x and z from common from these two terms. So we make a pair of this and this. Now we write these two terms, first plus 1 and then minus 1. Now we take x and z common from these two terms, and we left with x inside the bracket and here z inside the bracket. Now we take y square common, because there is y square, there is also y square. So take y square as common, and the plus sign is here. When the sign is plus, then there is no change inside the bracket. So this sign will come the same as negative. So we write negative here also. Take y square common, x is inside and z remains the inside of the bracket. Now we have two terms, this one first and this one second. There is a number common x minus z here, x minus z here. We take x minus z common. X minus z is taking as common, and we left with x minus z plus y square. So this is the complete factorization of such expression. Now we go to the next question, like 144 a square plus 24 a plus 1. As we have already learned in previous classes that a square plus b square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, this is the identity we use most often in our previous classes. Now we apply this identity in this question also. We can write 144 a square as 12 a square, because 144 is the square of 12 and a square is the square of a. So we make this as a whole square, 12 a square. And 1, as we all know that 1 is the square of itself, so 1 is the square of 1. So this is a square, this is b square, like here, a square and b square. We are required here 2ab. So we write here 24a as 2ab, in the form of 2ab. We write 2a is here 12a. You have to write this bracket and this bracket. This is one, without the squares. So this is 2ab. If we multiply these three brackets, we get 24a. We check it, 2 into 12, 24. 24 into 1, 24. So a, 24a. So we write 24a as 2 into 12a into 1. So this is a square, this is 2ab, and this is b square. So we can write this as the formula a square plus 2ab plus b square. As we know here, 2a, this is a plus b whole square. So this formula can be written as 12a plus 1 whole square. If we are given x square and we are required to factorize it, we write it as x into x. This is the factorization of this one. But what is the factorization of 12a plus 1 whole square? Like there is, here is x square, x whole square. We write it as x into x. Again, 12a plus 1 whole square. So we write it as twelve a plus one, like x into x. So 12a plus one. Again, this is another. We can apply here the other formula, identity, a square minus 2ab plus b square. We know that in the previous classes, equal to a minus b whole square, or a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. We apply this identity in this question. We write a square over b square in the form of a over b whole square, and b over a in the form of b square b over a whole square. We are required here 2ab. So we write 2 in the form of 2ab. How we can write it as? We write 2a. This is a here, a square, and this is b. So if we simplify this expression, we see here a is cancelled out with a and b is cancelled out with b. So we remains here only 2. So 2 can be written as 2 into a into b. So we have this formula, a square plus b square minus 2ab. We can write it as a over b minus b over a whole square. And whenever we have x square, we can write it as x into x. So this is also whole square. So we write it as a over b minus b over a into a over b minus b over a. So this is the factorization of such expressions. The next question is 3x square minus 75y square. If we see here, is there anything common in these two expressions? Yes, there is a common number which is 3. So we take 3 as common and we remains inside with x square. And if we divide 75 by 3, we get 25. So we write 25y square. If we multiply 3 inside, so we get 3x square and 3 into 25, 75y square. So this is the perfect factorization of such expression. Now, we have taken 3 common. Now, we see, is there anything common in the bracket? No, there is nothing common. So we make this expression in the form of a square minus b square equals to a plus b into b minus a minus b. We have also learned this formula and apply this formula in the previous classes. A square minus b square equals to a plus b into a minus b. Whenever we have two squares and the negative sign in between them, then we write the squares as 1 time plus, 1 time minus. So we apply this formula here. We can write x square as x whole square minus 25y square as 5y whole square. So this is a square minus b square. So whenever we have a square minus b square, this is a, this is b, so a square minus b square, there is minus. So we write it as a plus b, a minus b. So we write here 3 as it is, a plus b and a minus b. So this is the factorization of such expression. Now we take the next questions, next type of the question. Let us see question 4, x into x minus 1 minus y into y minus 1. There are two terms. First term is this one, second term is this one. Is there anything common in these two terms? No, there is nothing common. So we multiply first x inside and y inside. We get x into x, x square, x into 1, x. Y multiply inside, we have y square and y into 1, which is y, and minus into minus, plus. So we have now four terms. We rearrange them to make it possible its factorization. So we can write it x square and y square close to each other, or make a pair of these two numbers, x square minus y square, and x and y are the next pair, minus x plus y. What is the factorization of x square minus y square? We have learned in the previous question, like here, at a square minus b square is equal to a plus b, a minus y. Again, we have here x square minus y square. So whenever we have a square minus b square, whole square and the sign negative inside between them, we write it as x plus y and x minus y. And is there anything common? Yes, there is number common, which is 1 actually, 1x plus 1y. So we take 1 common from these two numbers, we get minus 1 common, and we remain inside with x and minus y. Why we write minus? Because minus minus makes plus, so there is plus. Now we have two terms, first one this, second one this. Is there anything common in these two terms? Is there anything common? Yes. What is the common? X minus y. So x minus y is common from bottom. This is x minus y, this is x minus y. What is left inside the bracket? X plus y. X plus y. And here x minus y taking common. So 1 is left here. Minus 1. So we write in the square brackets. So this is our factorization of such type of questions. The another type of question we are required to factorize it is this one. As in our previous questions, we use this formula a square plus 2ab plus b square equal to a plus b whole square. We apply this formula again in this question. How we apply this formula? We take x square separate, and these three terms, y square minus 6y minus 9, separate to make the formula this one. As we see, minus 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 is common in all three terms, so we take minus as common. So we remain inside y square plus 6y plus 9. Now we make this expression as a perfect square. How we make? Write y square as y whole square and 9 as 3 whole square. This is a square, this is b square, and we are required 2ab inside these two terms. So we write as plus 2a, what is a? Y. And b, what is b here? 3. So this is a square, this is b square, this is 2ab. So this is a square plus 2ab plus b square. And a square plus 2ab plus b square is always equal to a plus b whole square. So we write this expression as x square minus y plus 3 whole square. Now we make this as a whole square, y plus 3 whole square, a plus b whole square. Now we have two terms. One is this one and the other one this. This is a square, this is b square, and the negative sign in between them. So we apply this formula here. A square minus b square is equal to, we have learned already here, a plus b, a minus b. So we apply this formula here. We can write x square as x whole square, so this is a square, y plus 3 whole square, this is a square, this is b square, and the negative sign in between them, so this is a square minus b square. We write it as a plus b, a minus b. So we write a plus b and a minus b. This is whole b, so we write inside the bracket this one, a plus b, a or a minus b. Now we open this bracket, x plus y plus 3 x, now multiply minus inside the bracket, we get minus y minus 3. This is the factorization of such type of question. We have completed in this lecture our exercise 5.1. You can easily do this exercise by practicing at home. I have told you all types of questions in this lecture. So, dear students, you have to try at your home by watching this lecture. Now you are able to solve exercise 5.1. In our next lecture, inshallah, we are going to solve exercise 5.2. Till then, Allah Hafiz.